Karens, I am glad you came to talk to me. I have something to ask you.
I'm listening.
What do the women on your island do when they really like someone? Everything is so complicated where you come from.
In my culture, we do not talk about our feelings. Especially not amongst nobles. Marriages are arranged more often than not.
I knew it. Never mind. I'll do it my way. Your body and your soul are speaking with mine on Almanawi. And if you feel the same way, I would love to spend some time alone with you.
I would love that too. Meet me outside my room the next time we're at the house.
I will be there. Anything else?
I must leave you. See you later.
On Almanawi, do you still agree to spend some time with me?
Of course. I was waiting for this moment. Come.
I have never met someone like you on Almanawi. My heart has never beaten so fast for anyone. What about you? Do you think you are my Menundanem?
You are an extraordinary woman, Siora. And I had a great time in your company. But I do not share your feelings.
Estragme. I will still treasure this memory like I would a precious shell.
I'm glad you came to see me. I wanted to talk to you.
I'm listening.
I'm still a bit inexperienced when it comes to these emotional things. My feelings and my desires. But I believe that we share something unique. That a bond has been created between us. And if you were so inclined, I'd love to spend some time alone with you.
It would be my pleasure. Meet me outside my room the next time we return to my house.
I'll be there. Anything else?
I must leave you.
I'm a bit nervous. I've read many books on this subject, but they don't say anything about the way I feel right now. May I come in?
Come on. Forget about the books for a bit.
Yet another marvelous memory shared with you. And this one only belongs to us. I feel as if my heart is exploding. I've never felt this way about anyone. I suppose this is how it feels to be in love. Do you feel the same?
Yes, Aphra. I'm fairly certain this is love. And I love you too.
It's such a peculiar sensation. And it's so tremendous. Oh, my beloved.
Karens, do you need something?
I must leave you. Good day, Glendan.
Beort Tirtomat, Karans of Katasach. We learned of his death. Andevost Tire.
Alas, his was not the only tragic loss. Your High King, Vinbar, is also dead. He was taken by folly. He went away into his mountains after killing Katasach and capturing my cousin. Nothing I could say would allow him to see reason.
Are you telling me that you were the one who killed him, Kaer Tonsidach? What happened? How could a friend of Katasach do such a horrible thing?
I'm sorry, but your High King did not leave me any choice. He was at the point of killing my cousin, and then he attacked me. He was becoming a guardian, a Nardaig. Perhaps it was for that reason that he lost possession of his wits.
I believe you. You have sufficiently proven your friendship. But something escapes me. Why? Why would Vinbar have done such a thing? His offering to Tiafradi does not justify what he did.
You know that I wished to see Enonmil Frigdaman, and he was the only one with the power to allow me to do so. I would not have caused his death voluntarily. Believe me, I'm just as sorry as you.
Andevost Tire. We will celebrate his memory as well as those of all the members of our council that have fallen. Bloodnit, Katasach, and now our High King. These are dark times. But in spite of our mourning, we must elect a new High King. The children of Tiafradi cannot remain without a guide. All the more so in these troubled times. I will notify the Mal of all the clans so that they may know to travel here.
Who has a chance of being elected, in your opinion?
Deirdre is powerful, and many clans would follow her. The wisdom of Dunkas will also attract support from many, and there is also Ulan. A clever fox who is very capable of convincing the entire world with his honey-dripping words.
Deirdre, Dunkas, and Ulan. I must convince them to help me if they are elected.
I suppose. I must begin the preparations. You must leave now.
I must leave. Goodbye.
Qua awelam segi.
What do you seek?
I am the bearer of bad news. Your High King Vinbar is dead.
Dead?
Andevost Tire. He was a good king in times of peace, but he was plunged into doubt by your arrival. He was no longer at his people's side.
Glendan told me that you would be one of those keen to replace him.
That's true. If Bladnid were still here, I would have given her my votes and followed her into battle. But since she's no longer with us, I must obtain the title and do what should have been done a long time ago. Drive away the Renaixi and take back our island they want to enslave.
Will you drive us away too?
We will drive away the Renaixi. You are Onol Minawi. You will have to pick a side.
I see. If you were to be elected, I would need your help to allow me to meet Enonmil Frigdaman. Only he can help us cure the Malachor.
Why should you be preoccupied with a disease striking those we want to drive away?
I have my own reasons. But you should know this is the best way for the Renaixi to leave the island of their own accord.
You have helped my people. You are our Karants as well. You can count on me to help you. Once I am the High Queen, I will lead you to the sanctuary.
You seem certain you will obtain the title.
Those who covet victory must do everything they can to obtain it. Don't you agree? The old kings wore a legendary crown,
which was lost during the war against the people of the sea. Whoever were to retrieve it would be chosen.
And you know where it is?
I believe it is located in the Tomb of the Kings, a holy place not far from the village of Vignamri. I do not know exactly where it is, but it is said that the path leading there is strewn with spears, and that the entrance is marked by a dead tree, and protected by a Nadaig Magaman. Do not worry. I will find this place and retrieve the crown before the election.
If I want to be certain of the outcome of this vote, I'd better go and get this crown myself.
Anything more?
I need to be going.
Wa'awalem seg.
Now we have earned the trust of one of the pretenders. We just need to find that crown.
Hope you and your allies share the same ideas. Because once the crown is on their head, we will have to follow their course.
You're right. It's a decision that's more important than our quest for an antidote. I must dwell on it.
What brings you here, Ono Manawi?
I'm the bearer of bad news. Vinbar, your High King, is dead.
Ande voshtire. He was a great king, and a very wise Donegad. We haven't seen him in a long time, but his memory shall be honored.
Glendan told me that you would probably be among those who would want to take his place.
I am not looking for power. But Tirfradi needs peace and balance. And I fear the other kings may want war, or be motivated by ambition. The Renaissance brought chaos with them, and our island has suffered. We cannot change the past, and chasing away those who came does not make sense. The wound is there. Refusing to acknowledge it is pointless. But wounds can be healed, and my clan knows how to do this. So if you're worried about my intentions if I were to become High King, I'll lay them out for you. We must find balance with those from the remote island and live together in harmony. But for this, we must teach the Renaixe humility and to respect the Earth.
I would like to meet Enonmiel Frictiman. In order to find an antidote for the disease that is destroying my people. If you were elected, would you help me in this endeavor?
You are a Karantz of our clan, and I have witnessed your wisdom and benevolence. I would be glad to help you meet Enonmiel Frictiman, and I pray that he will help your people. But you should know that my election is far from certain. The spirits are divided. And some are thirsty for revenge.
Would there be a way to make sure that you get picked?
I do not like the idea of using such a method. But yes, there is a way. The High Kings of old wore a legendary crown, said to be a gift from Enonmiel Frictiman. The one who became the first guardian is believed to have taken it with him in death. If someone were to wear it in these troubled times, they would definitely be chosen by the others.
And where can I hope to find it?
In the burial mound of the High Kings near the village of Vignamri. But it is said that the path towards it is strewn with spears, and that its entrance, situated near a large dead tree, is guarded by a Nadaig Magaman. It is a deeply holy place, and the guardian will not let anyone enter without a fight. If you do decide to go there, fill your heart with humility and respect, for those who rest there were great men.
what do I owe the pleasure of your visit?
I regret to inform you that your High King, Vinbar, is dead.
And divorced Tyre. He was a great man, although he left us a long time ago. But why have you come to notify me of such sorrowful news?
Glendan has informed me that you are most likely among those who will want to take his place.
It is true. And I will perhaps be able to obtain it. I understand that you may be worried about my intentions, but rest assured, I seek only to bring peace to our lands. Peace brings life and prosperity. By creating an alliance with the people of the continent, the lives of our people will be improved and happier.
There is something I would like to ask of you. If you were to be named High King, I would be thankful if you could allow me to meet Enon Miel Frictiman.
Of course. If I become High King, I would be glad to help you. You are Carrance of Ignamri, after all. If you really want to make sure that I win, you will need to seek the crown of the High Kings.
What is that?
It may only be a legend, but it is said that High Kings used to wear a very ancient crown. The first guardian would have taken it to the grave. If someone were to wear it today, they would surely be chosen.
And where is the first guardian's tomb located?
Somewhere not far from here, since he fought his last battle nearby. The entrance to his burial mound is said to be guarded by a Nadaig Magaman. The path that leads to it, marked by his spears, and its entrance by a large dead tree. But beware. The Nadaig will not let you enter without a fight. Anything else?
Nothing. I must go.
What are you doing there? Here lie those who fell facing the first invaders, and you dare enter and scatter their bones.
I did not come here with the intention of defiling this place.
No. You came looking for a crown of the High King, hoping to choose the one who will lead us.
Isn't that what you were looking for as well?
Yes, but I am not a Renaigse. I wish to lead my people to victory, and I have come here seeking something that will make it a certainty. And so, do you plan on keeping it for one of those who is too wise or cowardly to come and get it themselves? Or will you give me the crown?
Once the power is in her hands, she will send a wave of blood and destruction over the entire island. I know that you are bound to this island, but think of the others, of us, of your cousin. Think about it.
Sorry, Deirdre. I believe someone other than you must become the High King.
Someone more easily manipulated, who will obey the orders of the Renaigse, no doubt. Too bad. You leave me no choice. I have come to take that crown, and I won't leave without it. Enough. I accept my defeat. Take this crown. I am not worthy to wear it, so it seems.
So it seems indeed. We will meet again at Dorhad Genedu. Until then, Deirdre. I went into the tomb. I found the crown that your ancient High Kings wore upon their heads.
And now you count on using it to lean upon the leader you have chosen to reign?
Yes. I need to be certain that the one elected High King helps me encounter Enon Mil Frigdemann.
I already promised you my help in this matter. But the question left unanswered is this. Do you wish that your people may continue to settle here? For our mutual benefit.
Take it. I hope you will keep your word and make good on your promise.
The Council is beginning to unite. It is time I left you. Thank you for having given me the crown. I will not forget your help. I promise you this.
Congratulations on your new position, Ulan. You will undoubtedly prove yourself worthy, but it's time you kept your promise. I must meet Enon Mil Frictamen as soon as possible.
I have not forgotten the gift you gave me when you handed me the crown, nor have I forgotten our agreement. But first, I must go to the sanctuary myself, Kharance, in accordance with our tradition. Meet me at the sanctuary's entrance. In 2 days, I will then have spoken with Enon Mil Frictamen, and I will be able to honor the promise I made.
In 2 days? Very well, I'll be there.
I hope you have some cards or dice on you to pass the time, unless you'd rather go somewhere else.
I'm glad to see you here, Kharance.
How was your encounter with Enon Mil Frictamen?
Very good. I accomplished the rites the way I was supposed to, and I received his blessing. He was concerned about the negative influence of a Renaixe, but I reassured him. Don't worry, but you should go. He's expecting you. Stay on the right-hand path, and do not turn back. Even the slightest hesitation could awaken the creatures who guard this place.
it was taken has returned. The flesh of my earth. You, by simply coming into being, have tangled the strings of destiny of all the other children. I am he they call Enonmilfrithimen. I have followed each of your steps since your arrival.
I hail you, Enonmilfrithimen. I have come to you to find a remedy.
A cure for the disease of a distant land. Her affliction was to be poisoned by her own children. Her veins rot in stagnant water. Her earth now bears poisoned fruit, and her children wither and die. And still it is those same children who can heal the lands, and with them heal themselves, if they only want it truly. They could be taught by my children, learn to give back in return, learn to heal. But for that, I must survive. I have seen by your side the shadow grow, taking form. Fed by the venom of intrigues from faraway lands, he spreads it today in my sap. To save his own life, he stole my strength, and that strength has driven him mad. Because it is not made to be taken. He draws each day a little more from me, and threatens us all. His hunger has no limit.
I don't understand. Who are you talking about?
The one you call Constantine. You must stop him. Or there will be no cure anymore for anything or anyone.
That's impossible. How could that be?
You must leave now. Someone has followed your footsteps. Someone has entered here without invitation. My children are waking and track him. They will attack all for us. Flee, or you will be dead.
I saw a man fleeing to Sanctuary. I should have warned you that you couldn't bring anyone with you. Were you able to get all the answers you were looking for?
Yes. He told me that the Malachor had appeared because of the way the Colonials have treated the Earth. It's actually some kind of poisoning. And it would be possible to cure it, but I'm not sure that I understood how.
Know that if we can help our allies, we will do it with pleasure. I am certain that the Donegada on the island will be able to help you make sense of what you heard.
Thank you, Ulan. I'll take some time to dwell on it.
You still look troubled. Does the fleeing man worry you?
No. I just learned a few things which I would like to verify.
I understand. For now, qua awalam seg Karans.
Goodbye.
My dearest cousin, I'm so glad to see you. You are right on time. We have visitors, and your advice would be most welcome. Let me introduce you to the emissaries of the Bridge Alliance and Teleme. Seeing them both in the same room is rather surprising, isn't it? But please, Your Excellencies, explain to us what brought you here.
Sire, I have come to humbly request your help. We have been sustaining terrible attacks.
Really? Are the natives behind this again? Unless it is those traitors of the guard.
We aren't sure, but it is almost certain that the natives are involved. Governor Burren is hoping that you could send him your cousin, as well as some troops.
It would seem that we are in a similar situation, sire. Our city has been sustaining terribly violent assaults, and our losses are great. Our mother cardinal is begging you to send her some help as soon as possible.
Dear allies, knowing that you are in such a delicate situation fills me with sorrow. However, the size of our troops has greatly reduced after the horrific attempt at a coup. Regarding sending my cousin, he's already very busy undertaking a mission of the utmost importance, without even mentioning the fact that what you describe fills me with fear for his life, which is most precious to me. No, I really don't see how I could be of assistance to you.
Constantine. We cannot remain deaf to the call of our allies. I'm sure I can find time to go and evaluate the situation.
I would love to accompany you, but my people are being wrongfully accused. I am certain of it, and I want to prove it.
Very well, my dear. You know I cannot refuse you anything. But remember how urgent it is for this antidote to be found. We are so close to it now.
Don't worry about it. You know how important this mission is to me.
Well, this audience is coming to an end. Your Excellencies, inform your governors of my cousin's arrival. I hope that you realize how grateful you should be to him.
Absolutely, sire. And we thank you both for receiving us.
May the Enlightened always keep you in his divine blessing.
Constantine,
my dear cousin. I am always happy to see you. What news do you bring?
I finally managed to enter the sanctuary at the heart of the island, and I was able to talk with Enon Miel Frictamen.
How marvelous! Tell me about it.
The sanctuary is heavily protected. Only a high king can open it.
I remember you saying that Vimbar's death wasn't going to help us. How did you fix this problem?
I had to interfere in the natives' elections and earn the trust of the pretender who seemed to be the best choice.
You really are an outstanding diplomat. My father is an old, bitter man, but he was right about you. Tell me, who did you choose?
Ulan, the king of the village of Vignamri. He's a negotiator and a clever diplomat who supports the presence of the settlers.
I'm certain that you have made the right choice. And then what did you do?
I was able to enter the sanctuary. It was an incredible experience.
It had to be. Oh, how I envy you. entering the most secret places on this island, talking to a god. What does he look like? Is he some kind of very old and very powerful Donegad?
No. In fact, I spoke to an extremely large tree, as strange as it may sound.
Fascinating. And I thought that gods were always old bearded men. Did he tell you where the Malachor was coming from? Is it a curse that he cast upon the first settlers?
No. According to him, we are responsible for the emergence of the Malachor. By exploiting the Earth so much, we have poisoned it. And the disease has contaminated us through the water that we drink and the plants that we eat.
Strange, and yet it seems plausible. So, there wouldn't be an antidote?
He says that the Earth can be healed. That his children know how to do it. I suppose he was talking about the Donegada. He also said that by healing the Earth, we would heal those who live on it.
This is a fascinating revelation. It won't be easy for our neighbors to accept it, however. I'm afraid that even my father might receive it with skepticism. Did he tell you anything else?
No. But it's true that the conversation ended abruptly. An intruder had managed to sneak into the sanctuary, and we had to flee to evade the wrath of its guardians.
An intruder, you say? Then I guess this sanctuary isn't that heavily protected. Your work really is exemplary. The entire continent should be thanking you. Is there anything you would like to tell me?
I must take my leave.
Take care, and come back soon.
Lord de Sade, I've been hoping you would come.
Your Excellency, I heard news of the attacks against Hikmet.
I am ashamed to once again rely upon your kindness, but our situation is quite desperate, and you have proven such a valuable aid to us in the past.
How might I be of service to you?
Animals, creatures have been attacking us relentlessly. They throw themselves upon our defenses day and night. They do not even try to avoid our weapons, rushing as if to swamp us in infinite numbers. Our best soldiers fall exhausted from fatigue,
The others die shredded by their claws. Please find the origin of these attacks and make them stop. If we cannot hold out, the entire population of Hikmet will be devoured. I sent a small group of trackers so that they might follow the trail of the creatures. Their last message came from a dangerous area in the hands of natives. The savages are certainly at the root of these evil attacks. Who else could have trained all of these creatures?
Could you indicate the zone in question?
Alas, no. I didn't get the information. You must meet their officer, who will know how to guide you there. She's leading our troops in the outpost at the entrance to the city.
Very well. I shall depart immediately.
Be so kind as to keep me informed. This affair is driving me to madness. Would you like to speak with me about any other subjects?
I have to go. Look forward to seeing you again.
Farewell, my lord.
You managed to make it through. A group of these enraged beasts managed to get past our defenses.
Yes, we fought and defeated them. But how did they make it through?
My men are exhausted. We killed some of them, but we were overrun. Our situation is getting more and more desperate. I don't suppose I need to warn you about the dangers of this road.
Actually, that is why we're here. Governor Burren sent me. He wants us to find a group of trackers.
And I hope that he'd sent you as reinforcements. Silly me. It looks like all we're good for is dying to protect his bloody city. But you wanted to ask me something.
Like I said, Governor Burren is hoping that I can find a group of trackers, with your help.
I'd like to see you try. Indeed, I was ordered to send out a party of scouts, which I did, despite our losses. They were supposed to find the bastard who's been sending us these critters. One of those savage sorcerers, no doubt.
Can you tell me which way they went?
Sorry, Your Excellency, I won't tell you anything until I receive some help. You have to understand, I hope that these men are alive. They are also under my command. But those who are here with me now are my main preoccupation. And as we speak, they're dropping like flies. Not to mention the fact that if this outpost falls, there won't be much left to protect the city. So you can go and tell the governor that if he wants me to help you, he will have to help us first.
I understand that your situation is desperate, that you want to take care of what appears most urgent. But it's not simply about me saving a few men. It's about stopping these attacks once and for all. By getting to their root cause, I intend to put an end to it. And then any help you hope to receive won't be needed any longer.
You hope that you will stop these attacks, but you have no way of knowing whether you'll manage to do so or not. Sorry, Your Excellency. Make sure you tell the governor what I've told you.
Maybe we can avoid going to the governor and save time. There aren't many of us, and I don't have any soldiers to give you. But perhaps I can still offer my help.
We were supposed to receive a shipment of ammunition and medicines, but we're still waiting for it.
If you can bring it to me, we would at least be able to heal ourselves and have enough bullets to sustain these assaults.
Do you know where this material came from?
From your city, New Serene. The caravan transporting it was supposed to pass through here 2 days ago. It must have been attacked. But with a little bit of luck, its cargo should still be intact.
Very well. I will retrace the path. It shouldn't be too difficult to find it.
The three of you won't be able to bring the crates back by yourselves. Two of my men will accompany you. Please, hurry. Without them, we're even less likely to hold.
We're departing right away. I must go. Goodbye, Captain.
Goodbye, Your Excellency.
Soldiers, are you the ones who are supposed to help me search for the caravan?
Yes, Your Excellency.
We're ready to leave as soon as you wish.
I'm ready. Let's go.
We'll follow you. Tracks of a heavy carriage. They must belong to our caravan.
Let's take a closer look.
I hope that those who are accompanying the caravan are still alive.
You have witnessed the violence of the attacks we are sustaining. They must all
be. A bit of poison on my blade. Let's go!
The beast who attacked it is still around. Be prepared.
They're all dead. They were torn to shreds.
But the cargo is still here, and it looks like it's in good condition.
As for the carriage, it's damaged. And without it, we'll have a hard time transporting this to the outpost. Do any of you know how to fix it?
There's a lot of work, but I should be able to do it. It'll take some time, though.
The beasts may come back at any moment. Make it quick.
I'm starting right away.
And don't worry. We'll protect you as long as necessary.
Ward off this. I did what I could, but it should hold.
And now we'll have to drag it all the way to the outpost.
Let's depart before more beasts arrive.
Here you are. I don't know how to thank you. Our cargo has finally arrived. With this ammunition, we'll be able to hold back the assaults, and the medicines have already given a boost to three of my men.
It wasn't an easy task, so I'm pleased that all this has been useful to you.
Here, take this. This is all I can offer to thank you, but I give it gladly.
Thank you, Captain. Now, can you tell me which way these trackers went?
They went towards the west, where the rebels are most numerous.
Are you talking about the Danaa Exregal?
If you like. The governor is certain that these savages are behind the attacks, so I sent my men to find their camp. This isn't the first time that we've tried to find them, but now our survival depends on it.
I see. Well, thank you, Captain. I'll try to find your man and put an end to all this.
Good luck. And if my men are alive, send them back here, will you?
You can count on me. I must go. Goodbye, Captain.
Goodbye, Your Excellency.